This is the RC30 B, a mini LED Fresnel style light that was just released. Thanks to SmallRig for sending me this light for early review and testing so I can share my thoughts about how this light might be beneficial to those of you who work in production or shoot in a YouTube studio like this. Links are down below in the description to purchase this brand new light. Let's dive right into the features, starting with the main highlight of this lens, which is it's basically a mini LED Fresnel light or like a zoomable spotlight. To me, it really could be classified as either one. I'll link some articles down in the description of this video that explains the differences between a spotlight and a Fresnel light. But the main feature is the fact that there's a lens on the front of this light to be able to change the beam angle of the light from 15 degrees to 60 degrees. This just gives you a different size of spot, so you'll have a little bit of a smaller spot at a 15 degree angle or a much wider spot at 60 degrees. Here's a quick demonstration with the light. You can see here at 60 degrees, we're getting a large fill on the background. It's a bit of a wider angle. It's not a full wash of the entire background like some of my other studio lights are, but as I push it around, move it around, you can kind of see it's creating that spot effect on a larger area. And that's at 60 degrees. But if we kind of zoom in with the beam angle, now we're at 15 degrees and we have more of a directional spotlight. And if we wanted to light a specific portion of a scene with that 15 degree angle, we could do that with this light like this. You can see on the table here how focused that 15 degree angle is versus the 60 degree angle. We zoom out, is much wider. So it's kind of cool to have a very versatile spotlight that you can change the beam angle for. That's only about the size of a lens or like a cup of coffee. In some Fresnel or spotlights, you're able to change the focus of the light, which will change sort of the softness of the edges of the light. You cannot do that with this spotlight, so that's important to know. There's no focus control, only the beam angle that changes the amount of spread in your spot. Practically speaking, I would not gravitate toward this light as a key light. It's pretty bright for only being like a 30 watt light, but you'd have to add a lot of diffusion on the light to be able to make it usable for a YouTube style setup like this. What I would use this for is for a high quality backlight that I can really control the amount of spill on my scene. Sometimes it's harder with these bigger lights that have a wider beam, a wider spread that just fill the entire space to be more directional with your backlighting, but this one is really directional and I can get a really nice rim light on a subject from behind. As far as power for the light, there's no built-in battery, so you do have to plug this in. This is an AC 24 volt power connector, and we just screw that right into the light. There's only two buttons you can press. There's an on button on the back of the light, and then a dial control to change your color temperature and your intensity. For color temperature, we have up to 6500 Kelvin, which is obviously this cooler color temperature, and we can go all the way down to 2700 Kelvin as well, which is obviously very warm. I always like when lights have a bi-color temperature. It's really nice to be able to dial in for your specific scene. With this light, we also get a cool set of barn doors to be able to shape this light even further than the beam angle. That 15 to 60 degree adjustment is great, but if you need even more control with your spot, you can throw on this, which is super easy to throw on. Literally all you do is push it onto the front of the lens and it's on, ready to go. So now you can shape the angle of this light. So we'll turn it back on here. So now we have way more control over the amount of spill on our scene, and we can really shape that light. If we wanted just like a little sliver of light somewhere, we could achieve that with these barn doors. Again, it's really great for being precise with your lighting. If I was lighting a subject here on the desk, but I didn't want light spilling onto any other part of the desk, I can do that with this light, and I can't really do that with any of my other studio lights. The size is obviously super small. I mean, I'm literally drinking just a cup of water here, and it's about the same size as a standard glass of water. It'll hardly take up any space in your bag if you're traveling, which is super nice. If you shoot in smaller spaces, something you could do is set these up on a track system on your ceiling and hang them kind of upside down like this, and then just have spotlights all over your studio, which is really cool. I love that design. I've seen studios, smaller studios, with that kind of design, but they always use larger lights that are like 3 or 4 times the size of this, even in a smaller space, which just isn't ideal for getting optimal results and managing your space properly. I could totally see myself adding a little track system right above my head to be able to slide this light kind of back and forth, and then dial in a backlight for me wherever I'm sitting or for some sort of object on my desk if I'm talking about it or shooting B-roll. There are just a few things I would probably change about this light if I could. First is just the menu interface is so simple. All you can adjust is your color temperature and your intensity. That's it. There's nothing else you can adjust. So I would love if there was just more functionality out of this light rather than on, off, color temperature, and power. There's also no internal battery power, so you always have to have this plugged in. This light would be super cool to be able to take, like if you were on a shoot out in the forest or something and you could just use it as a spotlight, that'd be awesome, except it's not possible. So you'd have to take 24 volt AC power out with you into the forest to make that possible. This thing is also built out of all plastic. It feels very plastic, very cheaply made, which is gonna help reduce the cost of this light and make it more affordable and accessible for people. But I wouldn't trust this light being rigged up super high in a janky way. If it falls, it's definitely going to break. This light is also super situational. I've been making content for 8 years and I've never really needed access to a spotlight in that 8 years time. I don't own one currently. This is the first one that I've had access to. So that probably tells me it's very situational and not something that has been a necessity in my production workflow up to this point. And on the flip side, I guess it could mean that since I have never had access to a light like this, it really just opens up another world of possibilities of what I can do in this YouTube studio or when I work with clients on brand sponsorships or working in my freelance production business. It just opens up some possibilities that I haven't really thought about before. So I'd be interested to see how this light integrates into my production workflow in the coming months. This light is now available for purchase and you can check it out down in the description below. Thanks so much for taking time to watch this video. If you enjoyed it, feel free to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already. I have a ton more videos you can watch on this channel right here. Thanks so much, guys. Much love.